Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 1, Lesson 14. The topic it is weather. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson goals for today. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to understand what the atmosphere is. We start by looking at the atmosphere. Atmosphere, it is that thin, hydrated gas above the Earth's surface, and it is held together by the gravity pull. So that is the one that ends the atmosphere. The atmosphere is hydrated. They are gases. And these gases are currents. They don't have any current. So that is how the atmosphere looks like. Or that is the way we can define the atmosphere. Now, when we talk about the atmosphere, it has four layers. Four main layers. One of them, it is the troposphere. The troposphere, it is that layer that is just next to the Earth's surface. Then, after the troposphere, we have the stratosphere. And this is just above the troposphere. After the stratosphere, we have the mesosphere. After the mesosphere, we have the one that is referred to as the ionosphere or the thermosphere. We have the diagram that we used to explain this. You can be able to see we have the troposphere, we also have the stratosphere, we also have the mesosphere and thermosphere before we come to the exosphere. But the main ones that we look at, it is the fourth thing. Let us look at their characteristics. Now, we start with the first one, which is the troposphere. What are the characteristics? One of the characteristics of the troposphere, it is the place where we have most weather phenomena occurring. This is the place where you get the cloud cover. It is the place where you get the dust. It is the place where you get the temperatures is changing. It is the place where you get the air pressure is changing. So this is the place where we have all the weather element being found. Number two, it contains the weather marking constituents or life supporting layer. So it is that part that contains all what it takes for the life. So it is the layer that will support life. Number three, when we look at the temperatures will decrease with increase in altitude. And this rate, we refer to it as normal lapse rate or the environmental lapse rate. And it is usually 100 meters rise. There is a difference, a decrease of 6 degrees Celsius. So you can get that. Then we have the pressure force with increase in height. Then when it comes to the air pressure, it will decrease as the height is increasing. At number five, rise to about 15 kilometers above the Earth's surface. It contains most of the atmospheric water, water vapor. We also have the cloud, we also have dust, and all the pollutants they are found in this place. Now, between the troposphere to the stratosphere, there is a discontinuity that we refer to it as the tropopause. And now, what are the characteristics of the tropopause? When you are in the tropopause, there is no change in temperature with increase in altitude. There is no change in temperature with increase in altitude. We go to the next one. The characteristics of the stratosphere. After tropopause, we just jump to the stratosphere. It is the second layer above the troposphere. It is that layer that is just above the troposphere. It consists of very little dust, water vapor, and snow crowns are found in this layer. The temperature increases with increase in altitude, a process known as negative rupture. What causes this? The stratosphere is a zone of ozone layer. And the purpose for the ozone layer, it absorbs the ultraviolet rays that passes the ionosphere, thermosphere, and it passes the mesosphere. So when it gets to the stratosphere, the ozone layer, ozone gas will absorb it. And that is the reason as to why the temperature will increase with increase in altitude. There is a steady increase in temperature that is caused over the concentration of the ozone gas. That one we have talked about it. Then when we go to the wind, a light in lower part but increases with increase in with height. And then the pressure would fall as the air is dry. Now, stratosphere is protective shield against the meteors that usually burn out as they enter the Earth's gravitational field. The upper limit is the stratopause that separate the stratosphere and mesosphere. And in this one, there is no change in temperature. We go to mesosphere. It rises above the stratosphere. It experiences a positive rupture, meaning that there is the temperature decrease with increase in altitude. Strongest wind and the lowest temperature experience. The layer of the discontinuity that separates the mesosphere from ionosphere is the mesopause. We go to the ionosphere. This is the last layer, which contains electrons and ions that influence the radio waves. Another thing, the temperature rises rapidly with the height until it gets 1,500 degrees Celsius. This is because it is also another ozone layer. It absorbs the ultraviolet rays that are not supposed to be reach the surface. That is the reason as to why those temperatures go to that. What is the composition of the atmosphere? It is mainly composed of hydrogen gas, oxygen gas, and other gases, which we refer to them as the inert gases, like argon. This is how it contains nitrogen 78%, oxygen 20%, water vapor 1%, argon 0.94%, and carbon 4 oxide 0.003%. Activity for today, list 4 layers of atmosphere. Another question, what are the characteristics of the troposphere? For more information, visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 1, that edition. You can get us through the SMSing to us. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. You can also tweet us. Otherwise, stay tuned to Adult TV. Thank you.